number 4 of our program, and this week we are going to work how to stay on top from knee on the belly, okay? It's a very good position to stay, okay? I use this position as a transition, but there is a position where you have a lot of attacks, okay? A lot of variability, variations to control and get in a better position, okay? So knee on the belly first, okay? This is the correct position. You want to stay with your shin on top of his bed, right here, okay? So it's called knee on the belly, but you want to work all with your shin. Your goal is to keep your partner on his back. So if it's turned, it's really a mistake, okay? He can work something from here. You want to keep all your weight on top of your partner, and the key of this position is your left knee, okay? Left knee has to be looking up, and your foot can't be too much close because it'd be easy for you to work attack from there. You can stay with your foot too much backward because you don't have a good base. So you want to stay here, okay? Your knee has to look up. So don't stay here. Don't stay, for example, here. You want to keep your knee up. It's like a concept of a single leg or double leg. So you want to make a double leg. Your knee is this foot, okay? He's going to help you to push, okay? To maintain the position. So from here, I always like to keep my hand on the hip, hand on the shoulder, right here. Now, when you roll, okay, in the gym, you can stay with your foot on the mat, okay, with your toes on the mat. Of course, in a competition, in a other fight, you can stay with your toes off the mat, okay? You're going to be weight more, okay, heavier on your partner. So we're going to work now a armbar, okay, from near the belly. Whenever who is on top, don't risk too much, okay? So don't make the mistake to push. Don't try to work the grips on the pants or on the collars. So we want to start first whenever someone on the bottom has the hand close to the neck. So I'm not able to work a choke. I'm not able to work on the arms like that, okay? So I'm going to start first my action. From here, I'm going to work on the arm that I don't want to attack, okay? Because he's defending his side and his neck. I'm going just to pull his arm close to my knee because I want to kill this arm. So look, I'm going to bring my other knee on top of his biceps, like here, okay? And be heavy on my knee. I'm going to switch another control and go with two hands around the pants outside, okay? I'm going to make the grips outside. There is always a free material that you can grab. So I'm going here. Now, I'm going to sit up, I'm going to make a turn and sit on top of his body. My knee has to finish sideways to his shoulder. I let go the grip on my right, but my left hand still on the pants. I'm going to focus on his elbow. I'm going to pull and pull his elbow in front of my belly. Hooking with my wrist to his wrist, move my body in the direction of his legs and step with my right leg on top of his head. So from here, I step and then you can move down, okay? Lay down. So you want to be heavy on your feet and this foot, your left leg, have to stay on top of his arm, okay? Don't do this, you don't need. You want to stay here and now, squeezing your knees, incline, incline the action of his legs, just